Lady Mama.
Everybody, Ryan Madura here, and I've got a fun bass lesson for you. This is one of my all-time favorite grooves, Lady Marmalade. You know, I knew it originally from the blockbuster smash Moulin Rouge, but before, it was LaBelle, Patti LaBelle. She did it. It was awesome. And this is just such a great groove to have. It's funky. It's guided by some fun theory, and it's just a great thing to have under your fingers. So today we're going to dissect this groove a little bit and show you how to play it. So if you want to get like tab or notation, anything like that, head over to my Patreon page or my Truefire channel and you can find it there. There's also tons of awesome goodies on my website, ryanmadura.com. But in the meantime, let's dig in and just get this groove under our fingers. So the most important thing to think about with this groove is, why are we playing this? What are the chords? I think that if you've been to this channel, you've probably realized that I love to do little like theory deductions when it comes to figuring out grooves. And this one is based on basically outlining a G minor chord and then going to C. So in this song, most of the movement that we're playing with is going to be going from G here on the third fret of our E string and playing a groove that kind of outlines a G minor 7 chord. And then arriving at our C chord, in this case, kind of like our 4 chord of the key. So we're basically playing a G minor. That's kind of our G minor 7 arpeggio, the root, the minor 3rd, the 5th, the flat 7th, and the octave. And then we're going to land on our C, which is here, our 4. So the basic framework is, as you listen to the song, they're really going like, do, 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 do. G, do, 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 C. And that's the basic fundamental concept that we're playing with. And the groove is based over this kind of G minor 7 chord. So to play the groove, what I'm going to do is instead of playing a regular arpeggio, I'm going to use some of the notes and I'm going to flip them around a little bit. So I'm going to go root, here's my 5th, here's my 7th, and then instead of playing the minor third down here, I'm gonna find it an octave higher. And it's right next to our 7th there, so it's pretty cool. The notes, if you're a note person, which we all should be note people, are gonna go G, D, F, B flat for that first beginning part. So I like to use my first finger and my pinky for this. You can see that I'm using my first finger, my pinky for the D, and then I'm using my first finger and I'm gonna kinda roll it from the F to the B flat. And those are the first couple of notes. So the cool thing again here is that like, we're really just playing notes of a G minor 7 chord, but instead of playing it as a standard like root, third, fifth, seventh, I'm kinda playing root, fifth, seventh, and I'm throwing that third on top. So I think that's pretty hip, and it falls really well on the fingerboard, so that's pretty cool. And to arrive at our C chord and to kind of finish up that groove, I'm basically going and playing the root, the 5th, the 7th, the 3rd, and then going with the 7th and the octave of the G, and then landing on our 4 chord C. So root, 5th, this flat 7th, the flat 3rd, the flat 7th, the octave, and then landing on our 4 chord. Or, note-wise, G, D, F, B flat, F, G, C, and there it is. Everything kind of falls really nicely between the 3rd fret and the 5th fret. This is a little slow, but it'll be good for you to get it. Just get the mechanics down. And there it is. That is the basic groove. Now, there are other parts of this song. It kind of goes the 4 chord, goes up to the 5 chord, meaning the C and the D at different points in time. And then there's that other super cool lick, which is great. And there's a trick to playing this one also, which is that, again, because we've kind of already established this G minor vibe of the song, when we play this lick, we're really playing to the notes of the G minor pentatonic. Our G minor pentatonic would be root, minor third, fourth, fifth, flat seventh or minor seventh, and octave. Or you can get that minor third up here, which is what I like to do. And this line follows just those notes. So if you can play a G minor pentatonic, you can play this line. It's going to start on the octave, this higher one, and then play octave, seventh, fifth, fourth, third, fifth, and then you go back into the groove. And it's super cool. Note-wise, we're dealing with G, F, D, C, B flat, D, and then back to the G. And when we land on that G, that will be the downbeat of returning to the groove. And there it is. So one of the coolest things about bass playing, I think, is the fact that we can kind of pull some of these theory lessons into play. And if we know what we're doing, if we know the chords that we're playing over, if we know some things like scales and, you know, rules of keys, then it's really easy to kind of figure out why certain bass players have played these epic grooves. And I would say that this one would fall under that category. It's an epic groove. It's one that you should know. It's a great thing to just sit down and play and rock out with for a while. And hopefully now you know how to play it. So again, if you'd like to get tab or notation or anything like that for this exercise, please head over to my website, ryanmedora.com. Check out my Patreon page or my TrueFire channel for things like that. Plenty of extra goodies, and have a great day. Happy practicing, everybody, and keep it groovy.